व्हाट यू डू? नाइन
I'm a student and preparing for comp I'm a student and preparing for competitive examination.
ओके, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम?
बैंकिंग एंड SSC.
ओके ओके, इट मीन्स दैट यू हैव ऑलरेडी डन योर ग्रेजुएशन. हैव यू डन योर ग्रेजुएशन?
Yes, I'm done with my graduation.
ओके ओके,
What
नाइस
about you?
नाइस. मी, यस, आई एम डूइंग बैचलर ऑफ एजुकेशन. एक्चुअली आई हैव कंप्लीटेड मास्टर्स इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर एंड एज ऑफ नाउ आई एम परसुइंग बैचलर ऑफ एजुकेशन.
बैचलर ऑफ एजुकेशन.
बीएड,
ओके, इट्स बीएड, राइट?
बीएड, बीएड, यस.
दैट्स गुड. वेर आर यू
सो आई
फ्रॉम
एम
बाय द वे?
डूइंग फ्रॉम हेयर अलीगढ़ मुस्लिम यूनिवर्सिटी. ओके ओके, आई लिव इन दिल्ली बट बेसिकली आई बिलोंग टू यूपी,
ओके, यू लिव इन दिल्ली एंड फ्रॉम यूपी, दैट्स
बट
गुड.
आई लिव इन दिल्ली. ओके महेश, व्हाई डिड यू ज्वाइन इंग्लिश टॉक?
I just want to work on my fluency skill as well as a little bit of hesitancy and sentence formation.
Okay, good, all right. And how long have you been learning English?
It's been 5 to 6 months approximately.
Okay, so I can see a lot of growth in you if you are learning, I think, for 5 to 6 months, but you are speaking well. Like, I can see the growth in you. I mean, you are very motivated.
Yeah,
And,
thank you.
okay, so Mahesh, before starting the session, I would like to ask you whether you want to talk about today's topic or anything else like general conversation.
We can have a general conversation.
Okay, and do you want me to give feedback at the end of the session?
Yeah, definitely. Your feedback is welcome at the end of the session.
Okay, nice, nice, nice. So, have you been to Delhi?
Yeah, last time, last year in 2020, I have been to Delhi.
So, where have you been in Delhi?
I went to my friend because one friend of mine is living there and preparing for UPSC exam.
Okay, so you must be going to like Lakshmi Nagar, Rajendra Nagar. There is a hub of coaching centers that where the students prepare for UPSC examination. Like there are 3 to 4 places where there are a lot of students leave because of coaching centers are there.
Yeah, students on. Yeah, I
Yeah. So have you been to any like monumental place or any? Have you been to Qutub Minar, any Jama Masjid? Or there are a lot of monuments here, like Humayun Tomb.
We went to Red Fort because at that time the farmer protest was going on, so it was not open, so we couldn't go inside the Red Fort. But yeah, and then there is this market in front of Red Fort. I just forget the name. It's Chor Bazaar or something.
Chandni Chowk.
Yeah, it's Chandni Chowk.
Okay, so what do you like the most about Delhi?
I like metro the most in Delhi. I love metro.
Metro.
Yeah.
Any like the transportation is there very good. I mean, the bus service, even the train service, metro. I mean, you
Yeah,
can
they're
travel.
fantastic.
I mean, you can travel. It's very cheap as well. It's not very expensive.
Yeah,
Like the
definitely.
facilities that is given by the government here, like the bus for 15 rupees. In 15 rupees, you can you I can even 30 within 30 or 40 rupees you can travel around Delhi. So there is no issue, and we metro is very good because like if you go by bus, there is a traffic issue in Delhi because a lot of traffic and a lot of traffic issues there in Delhi, but while traveling with metro, this is not a kind of issue. You can travel very easily, and there is no
Faster
time issue.
and you can travel faster plus safer then.
It's very safer and it's very faster because in Delhi, you know, the condition of Delhi air pollution is there, and even that kind of condition that most people avoid. Like even if you go outside, always there is a bus throng of people, bustling crowd, everything, lots of cars there, and you need to be very cost about if there's the old people. So it is very problematic for those people. Even it creates a problem for us as well, because even we are young, but now it seems like that we are suffering now because of air pollution here.
So these are the two things which I just didn't like about Delhi was traffic plus pollution, because its density of Delhi is very higher. That can be a reason.
Yes, that's because you can see, I like the most about Delhi is that health, medical facilities is there, education is there, and employment is there. So these are the three things that I find good about Delhi, and that's why people are coming here and living here. But the lifestyle is not good here. It's very very clear cut that lifestyle is not good. But if we as far as, but when it comes about health, education, and employment, it's the best in India. I very cheap, even compared to other cities like Bangalore or Mumbai. Comparatively, it's cheap, not expensive. Even the food is very cheap here. But when it comes to pollution, you know what is the condition here.
Yeah, definitely. So, do you live in hostel, room, or apartment? Where do you live?
No. My parents live here, so I live with my parents. And actually, my
Okay.
father job here, so actually we have been living here for 7 to 8 years. How many places have you been in Delhi? Where have you gone?
Not many, because we didn't have that much time. We have our train, so we have to return back. So that's why.
Okay, so how many days you stayed here?
Just one 2 day and one night.
Oh, it's very less. So that's why you didn't visit all the places.
Yeah, that's why we didn't explore much. So next time when I'll be visiting, so yeah, definitely I will have more days and nights, and then we'll explore Delhi.
Okay, so yes, nice. Can you tell me about some famous places about your native place, like Neemuch? Is there
Okay,
any
so
tourist place that people want to travel, where people travel?
in Neemuch there are many places. Like, if you want to visit like natural places, then you can visit Sukhanand Tirth, and there is Bhadwa Mata temple, which is very famous. It's known as Malwa's Vaishno Devi, so you can go there. And apart from that, near Neemuch, there is Athana Fort there. You can visit fort if you want to visit.
Yeah,
And
okay.
yeah, and apart from that, near Neemuch, if you go out of the Neemuch, then Chittorgarh is just 50 km far from Neemuch, so you also visit there. So that's
Okay,
amazing.
all right. So I think Madhya Pradesh, half of its area is covered with forest. I mean, the forest area is very bigger in Madhya Pradesh. It's very, I think Madhya Pradesh is good. I mean, it's the border areas like Gujarat and Rajasthan and UP. It also touch with Gujarat, na?
Yes, yeah, it's a good that
Yeah,
too.
Gujarat. I went to Mumbai 3 years back. Then the train goes between, like, move from Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, then Gujarat, then Maharashtra. That's how I went there by train. That's what I know, but I have never been to Madhya Pradesh, as I never visited any place in Madhya Pradesh. And you must, yeah. Anything else about Madhya Pradesh that you like?
Yeah, definitely. Madhya Pradesh is, I would say, safer than that of other state, because there is no natural calamities. Like, there is no tsunami, there is no earthquake, there is no volcano, there is no flood. So I would say it is safer, as it is known as the heart of India. So I would say it is the best place to live.
It's the same in UP as well. If you talk about the same issues, like there is no flood. Floods, yes, happens. Like when it rains incessantly, like even I can see sometimes in during monsoon season, it rains heavier in even Madhya Pradesh. I can see some areas flooded.
Like coastal areas, so where you can see tsunami often, And if you go to the north, then you will see snowfall and other landslide and anything can happen at any time. So I would say it's comparatively safer than other states. If I talk
हाँ
about the
बेस
coastal
लाइक
area, northeast, north and northeast, then.
यू मीन आई मीन हिंदी हार्टलैंड आर द स्टेट्स विच आर मोस्ट सेफर. यू नो हिंदी हार्टलैंड स्टेट लाइक यूपी मध्य प्रदेश छत्तीसगढ़ राजस्थान दीज ऑल आर हिंदी हार्टलैंड. दीज आर नोन एज वेयर पीपल स्पीक हिंदी. आई मीन 90% ऑफ पीपल स्पीक हिंदी देयर.
डेफिनेटली हिंदी
एनी
इज
अदर एनी अदर लैंग्वेज दैट पीपल ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश स्पीक.
अपार्ट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट डिफरेंट डायलैक्ट्स आर स्पोकन हियर लाइक मालवी एंड बघेली
डायलेक्ट
बुंदेली.
यस 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 डायलेक्ट इवन आफ्टर 5 किलोमीटर डायलेक्ट चेंज. इट्स अ कंडीशन ऑफ इंडिया. इवन यू गो 5 किलोमीटर अहेड देन डायलेक्ट चेंज. एनी अदर लैंग्वेज डू यू नो अपार्ट फ्रॉम हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश?
नो आई डोंट नो एनी अदर लैंग्वेज बट या आई नो डायलेक्ट्स लाइक राजस्थानी मालवी एंड लिल बिट ऑफ पंजाबी.
So if you are given a chance to learn different language, so which language will you choose?
ओके सो आफ्टर हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश आई वुड लाइक टू लर्न गुजराती.
Why?
बिकॉज इट्स क्वाइट इट साउंड्स वेरी गुड एंड आई लव दैट लैंग्वेज व्हेन दे स्पीक. एंड अदर देन दैट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ हरियाणी. आई जस्ट लव हरियाणी एक्सेंट एंड हरियाणी पिचिंग ऑफ द वर्ड्स एंड एवरीथिंग.
Okay, and when it comes to employment, which language is the best according to you?
Employment, then it's definitely English.
English. And there's a lot of combination of English. Like there's a lot of opportunities like English Arabic, English French, and English Chinese. This is a language that this is a combination of language that if you learn these languages together, then it is a very like employment generated languages. This provides a lot of employment opportunities. Those people who have learned English plus Arabic, they are very doing well in their careers. Even Hindi and English is also good. This is a combination. But if I talk about both two foreign languages is the best option. I mean, if you know the two foreign languages like English and any other language like European, like Spanish, Chinese, and Arabic, these are the
French,
top. French, yes, French as well. So these are the languages that for employment. I mean, for the employment, if you want to excel in your career, then this is the best language if you can choose. Otherwise, for your interest, you can choose anything like Gujarati, Hindi, Urdu as well. So this also Urdu. I mean, Urdu and Hindi are the these are the very similar language. But there is some. If you know Hindi, then you can absolutely learn Urdu within 1 or 2 months or 3 months more than.
Yeah, they are quite similar.
Similar, but in writing it's very totally different.
Yeah,
While you can speak, but when it comes to reading,
writing it's
it will take
totally
time.
different. Yeah,
Yes,
you can't
yes,
write
yes.
even a single word of Urdu. That's very difficult.
Yes. We are almost already at the end of the session. And as far as your feedback is concerned, I mean you are very motivated and you are doing hard work. I mean, for even you are learning English for 5 or 6 months, but I mean you are doing very great here. And I mean you have just have to practice yourself and try to practice and try to speak every day. Even if you're trying to speak every day, like even for 1 hour or half an hour, that's how you will improve. Like the listening, speaking, reading, writing. These are the 4 steps you already know. You must know. These are the
Yeah, I know
steps
all this.
you can do that. Try to listen, try to speak, try to read, and try to write. These are the 4 steps, and definitely within 4 to 5 months, your fluency level will increase day by day. That's how you know. Try to work one upon your vocab. Try to learn some new word that you find. If you read any novel, any even newspaper, you can find new words. And if you find new word, then you'll absolutely learn if you're motivated to learn any language. So
Sure.
that's how you will improve and practice daily. That's how. And I don't think any problem here. Okay.
Okay, definitely. I'll continue it and work on that.
And it was nice having talked to you. Thank you so
Same,
much for
same,
joining.
same. Thank you
Okay,
so
man.
much.
Thank you. So what you